future technology according to the imagination. In many respects, human imagination is more complicated to imitate than human enterprise. But human imagination, at any given moment, is restructuring the future and the world around us, big and little. Welcome back to the channel. We've used our futurologist far-seeing goggles for future technology and created a list of some of the most interesting future innovations that will have a great, huge impact on the globe. Okay, here we go. Number 10, lab-made dairy products. But what about other animal-based foods? Biotech companies around the world are increasingly interested in creating dairy products in the lab. People think they've cracked it. The dairy industry isn't very green. It accounts for more than 4% of the global CO2 emissions, surpassing both air travel and shipping. Dairy is easier to synthesize than meat. Most researchers aim to ferment it, so to produce the milk proteins, whey and casein, rather than grow it from stem cells. Products like Perfect Days already exist in the US, with ongoing research on replicating the mouthfeel and nutritional benefits of regular cow's milk. Researchers are also working on making mozzarella, other cheeses, and ice cream in a lab. Number 9. Digital twins that monitor your health. Humans can stroll into the medbay in Star Trek, where many of our ideas for future technology were conceived, and have their complete bodies digitally examined for illness and injury indicators. According to the developers of QBio, using this solution in the real world will result in improved health outcomes while also lowering doctors' workload. The US company has developed a scanner that can measure hundreds of biomarkers in less than an hour, ranging from hormone levels to fat accumulation in the liver to markers of inflammation or any number of cancers. It plans to use this information to create a digital 3D avatar of the patient's body, known as a digital twin, which can be followed throughout time and updated with each new scan. Number 8. Eco-friendly funerals. Faced with the reality of climate change, people prioritize sustainable living. But what about eco-friendly dying? Death is usually a carbon-intensive process, leaving us with one final environmental footprint. According to reports, the average cremation emits 400 kilograms of CO2. So, what's a better option? You might be composting in Washington State. Bodies are placed in chambers with natural decomposers like bark, soil, and straw, and in 30 days, your body becomes soil and can become transformed into a garden or a forest. 1/8 of carbon dioxide produced by cremation is claimed to be consumed by recompose. Fungi are used in biotechnology. In 2019, the late actor Luke Perry was buried in a custom-made mushroom suit by Coio. In addition to helping decomposition, the company claims its suit neutralizes poisons released by decaying bodies. Most alternative methods of disposing human bodies after death are not based on new technology. They await social acceptance. Another is alkaline hydrolysis, which involves slicing the body into chemical components for 6 hours. It's legal in many US states and produces fewer emissions than other methods. Number 7. Synthetic eyes. For decades, bionic eyes have been a staple of science fiction. But real-world research is finally catching up with farsighted novelists. A slew of technology is on the way to help people with various vision impairments regain their sight. In January 2021, Israeli surgeons inserted the world's first artificial cornea into a 78-year-old man who was born blind on both sides. Following bandaging, the patient was able to read and recognize family members right away, without being rejected by the patient's body. The implant integrates seamlessly with human tissue. Similarly, Belgian scientists developed an artificial iris that may be attached to smart contact lenses to correct a variety of eye impairments in 2020. Scientists are even working on a wireless brain implant that does not require the use of eyes. Monash University in Australia is conducting tests for a system in which users wear a pair of glasses equipped with a camera. This delivers data directly to the implant, which lies on the brain's surface and provides the users with a basic sense of sight. Number 6. Drone and flying taxi airports. Our congested cities definitely need a breather, and relief may come from the air rather than the roads. Plans for a new type of transportation hub, one for delivery drones and electric air taxis, are actually coming to fruition, with the UK government funding the first urban airport. It's being constructed in Coventry. The hub will serve as a pilot project and, perhaps, a proof of concept for the company behind it. The goal is to eliminate the need for as many delivery trucks and create personal automobiles on our roads by replacing them with a clean alternative in the shape of a tiny new type of aircraft, with designs being developed by Hyundai and Airbus, among others. The importance of the infrastructure cannot be overstated. Organizations such as Civil Aviation Authority are investigating the creation of air corridors that might connect a city center to a nearby airport or distribution center. Pretty dang cool, huh? Number 5. Infection-detecting smart sutures. How can a doctor tell if a patient's wound is infected? They could either wait for the patient to show signs of infection, or they could speak with a high school student from Ohio who has created an inventive and life-saving innovation. Dasia Taylor devised sutures at the age of 17 that change color from brilliant red to dark purple when a wound becomes infected, detecting a change in the skin's pH level. When an injury or operation wound becomes infected, the pH rises from 5 to about 9. Taylor discovered that beetroot juice spontaneously changes color at a pH of 9 and utilized it as a dye for suture material. While other solutions exist, smart sutures coated with conductive substances can monitor the status of a wound through changes in electrical resistance and transmit a message to a smartphone. They are less useful in underdeveloped nations where smartphone use is not exactly popular. Number 4. Bricks that store energy. Scientists have discovered a technique to store energy in red bricks used to construct buildings. Researchers led by Washington University in St. Louis in Missouri, U.S., have found a way for transforming inexpensive and widely available building materials into smart bricks that can store energy like a battery. Although the research is still in its early stages, the scientists believe that walls composed of these bricks may store a significant amount of energy and can be recharged hundreds of thousands of times within an hour. The researchers devised a technique for converting red bricks into energy storage devices known as supercapacitors. This entailed applying a conducting coating known as PEDOT, P-E-D-O-T, on brick samples, which subsequently seeped through the porous structure of the burnt bricks, converting them into energy-storing electrodes. According to the researchers, iron oxide, which is the red pigment in bricks, aided in this process. Number 3. T-shirt that monitors your heart rate. Wearable sports bands that measure heart rate aren't new, but accuracy varies widely, especially if you rely on them to count calories. This is fine if you only want to know how hard you're working, but precision is critical for experts. A single lead ECG printed into the fabric of this revolutionary t-shirt from innovative materials startup Chimera precisely measures heartbeats and sends them to the cloud via Bluetooth. Then, algorithms process the data to detect arrhythmias, which could save a life. Not only athletes stand to gain, though. This product's potential for both athletes and the general public is actually pretty astounding. It is envisioned that it'll likely be used clinically to provide adequate notice of a heart attack for those with heart issues. 2. Self-driving cars. We've practically become accustomed to the concept of driverless automobiles before you even see one on the road. After all, logistics make the world run around you so that you might see a lot more driverless trucks in the future. They will be less expensive to operate than standard rigs because they drive more smoothly and consume less fuel. Because computers never wear or require rest, they can take longer journeys. They might also travel in convoys, nose to tail, to reduce wind resistance. Companies such as Mercedes and Peloton are currently investigating these options. And if the anticipated gains materialize, freight companies might upgrade entire fleets overnight. On the flip side, it may immediately put drivers out of employment, as well as personnel at truck stops set up to repair them. However, several corporations have stated that the vehicles will still require human passengers to assure the safety of their cargo. I guess that means they're just going to be on Angry Birds the whole time then, right? That's an outdated joke. Number 1. Fast charging automobile batteries. Fast charging electric vehicles are critical to their adoption since drivers will be able to stop at a service station and fully charge their car in the time it takes to buy a coffee and use the restroom, which is no longer than a regular break. However, this quick charging of lithium-ion batteries can lead to degradation, according to US researchers at Penn State University. Since lithium ions can't flow as easily from one electrode to the other during charging at lower temperatures, i.e. during rapid charging, this happens. However, they've now discovered that heating the batteries to about 60 degrees Celsius for just 10 minutes, followed by rapid cooling to room temperature, prevents the formation of lithium spikes and heat damage. Self-heating batteries use a thin nickel foil to generate a heating circuit that warms the inside of the battery in less than 30 seconds. To quickly cool the battery after charging, the cooling system of the car is used. So, that's all for today. Comment on your wonderful, illustrious imagination in the comment section down below. And hey, thanks for watching.